morning, guys. I'm just leaving Davinder and Claudia's house. I'm putting some air in my tire and ready to go. Davinder, Claudia, thank you for everything, guys. Be safe, Ricardo.
You are the greatest chef and amazing motorcyclist.
See you! Hey guys, I'm still in Terrace. That's so disappointing. As I said, I got a flat tire. I put a plug. I tried all the possible place asking someone to help me to fix this tire. But unfortunately, by law, they cannot fix and put pads or plugs in the tires because they are afraid of lawsuit. In other words, I will have to do the repair myself. I'll keep you guys posted, man. That's so frustrating. Nobody in Terrace can help me to fix my tire. I tried 3 different tire shops. The only option they were offering me is to put a tube, but I don't want to put a tube because if I get flat in 1 hour, for example, or 2 hours, whatever, I cannot use my plug. Guys, I am still stuck in Terrace because a single flat tire. I put a plug, it's not holding it, and this guy in front of me, very nice guy, I met him on Walmart, and he said he's gonna ask his friend to kind of do this patch in my tire for me because it's illegal in Canada. Can you believe it? The only option I have is to buy a new tire, which I will not, or to put a tube, which I will not either. My tire is tubeless, and the reason that I will not put a tube, if I put a tube and I get a flat tire again, I cannot use a plug. To get the things worst, I bought a brand new air pump on Walmart in New Jersey. It doesn't work. I went to return it. They did not accept it because I'm in Canada. And then I had to buy another pump, and let's see how it goes. I just cannot continue my trip to Alaska without having my tire fixed properly. Imagine if I'm in the middle of nowhere, no help, no tire shop, nothing. Yeah, hopefully this gentleman that I'm following will help me to fix my tire. I woke up 7 in the morning, it's 11:30, and I'm still circling around trying to resolve this problem.
A few moments later.
Guys, believe me or not, I am still stuck in Terrace, but a very nice guy, his name is Mark, I just met him on Walmart. You know, he's gonna try to fix my tire. Hey Mark, say hello to everybody in Brazil and the States.
Hey, we don't leave a biker stranded, right? That's a biker code.
Yeah, absolutely. I always say the highway is a mother that introduced all the sons for us, and you're going to be one of those. Yeah, brother, whenever you go to New York City, I want to do double back to you.
Yeah. Oh, no, you don't even worry about it. I expect nothing.
No, but I do. I do. Absolutely.
Never leave somebody behind.
Look at his shop. Yeah, hopefully we're gonna be able to fix my tire. I mean, I put a plug there, the plug, it's holding it so far, but I don't know how long it's gonna last. I'm still here with Kent, Mark, amazing guys. They already treat me with a Coca-Cola, you know, they're figuring out the way to fix my air pump. And stay tuned, guys. They are amazing. You know, I'm in trouble because when they go to New York, I have to take them for a dinner on Daniel's. Thank you, guys.
Mark, Kent, thank you very much for everything. God bless you guys. Hopefully, I do not have a problem with my tire anymore because now I have, you know, air pump, and I'll keep you guys posted. Thank you, man. Thank you for having me.
Nice to meet you.
Folks, believe me or not, more rain, and my final destination is about 2 hours. I'm on route 37, going to Stewart, and right after is Hyder, Alaska already. My next filling station is probably in 1 hour. They call Mesa Junction. It's the junction of Route 37 and 37A. Hello, guys. This is the famous Mesa Junction. There is an intersection there. If you go straight left, you go to Hyder and Stewart. That's the place I'm going to spend my night tonight. And if you go right, you're going to Alaska Highway, which is right over there. You see those cars coming? When you go that direction, you're going to Alaska Highway. That's why they call 37th Junction. Everybody stops here to gas it up. Hey guys, I just filled it up here at the Mesa Junction. I saw a bear probably half mile from here, big one. I was making a curve and he was crossing, but he was so fast. He crossed in front of me, and I didn't even have a chance to hit the button in my GoPro. Okay, that's the Mesa Junction. If you go right, you go to Alaska Highway, which is my case tomorrow. If you go left, you go to Stewart and Hyder. Hyder is already Alaska. I'm gonna sleep tonight in Stewart, and tomorrow I'm going to Alaska Highway. Stay tuned, guys. Hope you are enjoying my expedition New York to Alaska. Guys, get ready. I goosebump every time I arrive here. That's the Bear Glacier. I mean, you never ever would have the real idea how beautiful and how big this is. I have few different pictures here from every time I come to Alaska. Oh my goodness, I can't believe I'm here again. Please write a comment. I want to feel motivation in this group. Tell me, what do you think about
this amazing glacier.
Another 360 degree for you guys. You have no clue how beauty this is.
Guys, unbelievable. Everywhere you go, it's fog, and if you can see the water, it's almost the same level of the road. Everywhere you look, it's fog and water. You're gonna see the level of the water in comparison to the level of the road. Guys, I missed the second bear. They're so fast, they just cross ahead of you, one side to the other side of the road, and I never get the chance to be fast enough to click. And also, when you click the GoPro video, there is a little delay. Is it pretty or what? Oh man, I love being here. Last time I was here was before the pandemic. Oh man. I feel alive. I feel pioneer. I feel so amazing every time I come to this place. I just made it through Stewart, British Columbia. And 4 blocks from here is Hyder in Alaska. It's very funny because you are in Stewart, British Columbia, and 4 blocks down, you are in Hyder, Alaska. That's kind of the main street. I always stay in this hotel on the right side. The name is King Edward. That's the place I'm going to stay tonight. And yeah. I made it. I'm so happy because I was so preoccupied with my plug, but all went well. Look how beautiful it is. It's unbelievable how tall those mountains are.
Hello everybody, I just made it at Stewart, British Columbia, and let me show my motorcycle, my hotel, and I will give you a 360 degree so you have some clue about the city. I was so worried because I put a plug and hopefully the plug was, you know, holding it for almost 4 hours, but for God's sake, if something happened, nobody in this area can fix your tire. Stay tuned. King Edward Hotel, Main Avenue. By the way, those mountains are so tall. That's the place I normally stay. And 4 blocks down, it's Hyder, Alaska. Believe me or not, I am exactly in the board. 4 blocks down, Alaska. I decided to stay one more day in Hyder and Stewart because the weather is supposed to be better than yesterday, and now I'm going to Fish Creek, trying to see some grizzly catching the salmon.
I decided to stay one more day here. September 2nd, it's my birthday, and now I will be crossing the board from Stewart to Hyder in Canada. It's like 4 blocks away from the hotel, and I just met that fellow in front of me. We're going to Fish Creek to see if we can see the grizzly hunting the salmon. Well, yeah, I decided to postpone my trip heading to Fairbanks for tomorrow. I was gonna leave this morning, as you guys know, but I said, you know what, I'm gonna stay one more day. You see, entering Alaska. Welcome to Hyder, Alaska. In fact, it's about 4 kilometers from Stewart, from the hotel. They call Hyder Ghost Town. You wonder why, right? Now I'm gonna buy some tickets from Caroline to go to see the Fish Creek.
We are in Hyder, Alaska. Now I will buy a ticket to see the Fish Creek. It's the place that normally the bears goes to catch the salmon. The mountain over there is Canada, and right here, Alaska. Just met this amazing fellow from Kitimat. We are gonna be riding together to see the Fish Creek, and hopefully we are gonna see some grizzly. Yes, let's go.
Hopefully fish for sure.
Oh yeah, if there is no bears, we are gonna be eating salmon at least. Let's go there.
Yeah.
Hey guys, we are so lucky. There is a big grizzly there eating a salmon. As I promised you guys, there it is, big grizzly. Guys, the bear is chasing the salmon. We have a lot of salmon here. We cannot make a noise. Another one for you guys. Look how many salmon we have.
Eventually.
You can see them posts that are in the water way over there.
Yeah.
Those are from the railway, and the railway ran up to the end of the valley, where there was a couple of mines that had tramways that come down, and they're a little closer here.
Yeah.
And they were from the road when they first built up.
Hello everybody, I'm Stu in Stewart and Hyder. And this morning I went to see the grizzly bears catching salmon. And now I, you know, I took a bus with a nice guy. He has a, you know, he has a tour company here, and we are going to Salmon Glacier. I didn't come in my motorcycle because the road is pretty bad, and my motorcycle is not for off-road. I'm gonna show you the road as well, the scenery, which is very beautiful. That's the bus. That's how bad the road is. And now let me show where are we going. We're going to that glacier, Salmon Glacier. It's so beautiful. I've been there a few times, but today, you know, beautiful day, I decided to pay for a bus. It's $100 Canadian, but worth it. As you guys know, my motorcycle is RT, and I did in the past 3 times, but it doesn't worth, you know, you destroy your bike and the tire is not proper for this kind of roads. Besides, if you find a bear, as it happened to me in the past, you have no time to make a U-turn. That's the reason I took a bus, and you know, I did not regret at all. Thumbs up if you like it, and please subscribe if I deserve it. Thank you. Hello everybody, Ricardo again. I will show you again the Salmon Glacier, which is 35 kilometers from Stewart. This place is pretty amazing. Isn't it pretty or what? Well, that's pretty high, pretty beautiful.
Yeah, that big chunks of ice down there, you know, those are probably the size of a 3-story apartment block.
Oh yeah, big time. Guys, I'm at the top of the mountain. I'm gonna show you this amazing view. Isn't it something or what?
Meanwhile,
hello folks, I'm still in Smithers. Tomorrow is my birthday, September 2nd. I am pretty excited about it, and you know, I'm gonna get a couple of beers here in this restaurant, amazing food, and yeah, tomorrow my destination will be this lake. I will not put so many miles because I am pretending to sleep so late tonight. But tomorrow, I definitely will drive like 5 hours. Thank you guys, stay tuned.